Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1911, Mega Millions Lottery, find the most popular numbers. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, today I have a question that is definitely related to work, particularly if your goal is to win the lottery and never have to work again. Now, I got an email from someone who had watched episode 453. This is from almost 5 years ago. And right here at the 111 mark, I made this offhand comment that I said I was going to use data text to columns to convert the data from the way that you download it to this format. And when I went back and watched it, I did not explain that well at all. So it's time to update this video, and we're going to go a little bit slower than normal today, but still, it's going to be a relatively fast video. Anytime you see this red box pop up on the screen, that's a great time to press pause and write down the formula that I used. All right, the first thing we have to do is download all Mega Millions winning numbers, and this has gotten harder. At least the Mega Millions website doesn't have the download as CSV anymore, but if you search Google for download all Mega Millions winning numbers as CSV, it should take you here. At least the Texas lottery is offering that, going back to 2003. So right here, we click download file, and they have downloaded. So I'm going to open that. All right, now it's a little frustrating that there are no headings. So we're going to insert a row. I'm going to choose row number one. I'm going to right click and say that I want to insert. That gives us the row for the headings. And this is game, this is month, this is day, this is year, and I'm going to call this one regular one, was regular space one, and then with that cell selected, I'm going to grab the little square dot, the fill handle, see the black plus sign there, that's when you know you're in the right spot, and drag that over five rows, and then this is the mega ball. And finally, if your state has the multiplier, this is the multiplier. I know that not all states have that. Okay, now, here's the data that we downloaded from the Texas website. And unfortunately, it is not perfect. We're going to have to add some fields before we can even do the trick to get it into the right format. And the first field has to go here between the year and regular one. So I'm going to right-click on the E for regular one and insert, and I'm going to call this date. And the way that we're going to get the date field is we're going to say equal, D-A-T-E, open parentheses. I'm going to use the mouse and click on the year, comma, use the mouse and click on the month, comma, use the mouse and click on the day. Closing parentheses and press enter, and that gives us a date. So this data is going all the way back to 2003. Now once I have that formula selected, the cell with that formula selected, again, I'm going to go to that little square dot. When I see the black plus sign, I'm going to double click, and it will copy that formula down. Don't worry about those pound signs there, those hash signs. Just need to make the column wider, and we'll be able to see the dates. All right, so there's our first trick. Now, from here, we can actually do what we call the unwind process, where we take these numbers that are going across and make them go down. Unfortunately, if you're in Excel 2007 or 2010 or 2013 or something even newer than that, they've hidden this command, so it's really hard to get to the command. The first thing you have to do is hold down the Alt key and press D. D as in David. And you see up here we get the Office Access key, Alt D, and then press the P. P as in Paul. So Alt D P, which stands for Data Pivot Table, brings up the old wizard here, and we can choose multiple consolidation ranges. We'll click Next. In step 2A, we say that we're going to create the page fields. Click Next. And then for the range, we want to start here on this date field. And I'm going to hold down the Shift key. I'm going to go use the right arrow key. So Shift right. Select that range of data from date through the mega. And then Control and Shift, hold down both of those, and down arrow to select that entire range. And then we can click Finish. All right, now, hey, for those of you who watch the podcast regularly, you know that just last week I used Power Query to do this exact same trick. However, I'm assuming that since Power Query is only in Excel 2010, and the people watching this may not have Power Query, I'm doing it the old way. So yes, there would be a faster way to do this with Power Query, but you'd have to go through and download Power Query. And plus, if you don't have Excel 2010, you know, then it's more of a hassle. All right, so here we are. Here's our, this looks exactly like what we just had. I realize that. I want to click here in the grand total column and press the control key and the down arrow key together to get down to the last row with data. And from here, we double click. Get a brand new sheet, and this sheet now has the information that we need in the order that we need it. So here in A1, I type the word date, and then B1, I'm going to type the word type, and then finally in C1, I'll type the word number. Now, a few more things that I want to do to make the analysis more usable in the end. So over in column D, let's type the word year, and the formula here is going to be equal YEAR, year of that date, and that will give us the year 2003. That way we can take a look at the most popular numbers in each year. I'm also going to add another column called New Game. New Game. The Mega Millions changed on October 22nd of 2013, and before that there were, I think, only numbers up to 56, and now there's numbers, I don't know, there are higher numbers, I'm sorry, I don't know off the top of my head. And so we have to know if this drawing is from the new game or the old game. So we're going to say equal if the date, so A2, is greater than, and then I'm going to use the date function, open parentheses, of 2013, comma, 10, comma 21. If it's greater than October 21st, then we know that we have the new game. Otherwise, it's the old game. And again, double-click the fill handle to copy that down. All right. So now we have the type, whether it was the mega ball or a regular ball. We have the number that was drawn. We have the year. Also over there in column A, we have the date in case we'd ever need to go back and see that. And we have this column that tells us whether it's the new game or not. One more thing I'd like to do is I would like to get the type in column B to be just the words mega or regular. And so I'm going to come over here and create something called type 2. All right, now what I want over here is just either the word mega or regular. So we're going to ask for the left of that cell, B2, comma 7, because there's 7 letters in regular. Now, when there's less than that, like in mega, it just gives us the 4 letters. But see, it's essentially cutting off the 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, there we go. We now have the data in the format that we need to do the analysis. And to do this analysis, we're going to create the real pivot. It's pivot, pivot table time. Built the pivot table that's going to be useful. So if you're in Excel 2007 or newer, we're going to come here to the Insert tab, choose Pivot Table. Sources table range 1, and we're going to go to a brand new worksheet. Click OK. All right, so we want to see the numbers down the left hand side. I'm going to take this number field and drag it to where it says rows. All right, so there's all the various numbers. And then I need to know how many times each of those rows appeared. So I have to take some text field. In this case, I'm going to use the type field and drag that to the values area. So now I can see for each number how many times they were drawn. And then I'm going to take the type 2 field and drag that to the filters area. Also, we'll take the new game field and drag that to the filters area. All right, a couple things. So here's all the numbers. It looks like we probably have numbers from 1 down to 75. And we want to see which numbers were the most popular. So I'm going to choose one cell. It has to be just one cell over there in column B, like the first number here in B5, and on the data tab, we'll click Z to A. All right, and so now over the entire life of the game, at least the life of the game in Texas, which goes back to 2003, these 5 numbers are the most popular numbers. However, again, as I said, before October 22nd, 2013, they had a smaller pool of numbers, and so the higher numbers, of course, were drawn a lot less. So to be completely fair here, we have to go to New Game and ask for just true. Click OK. And now we're seeing the most popular numbers since the game changed in October of 2013. And so 10, 3, 9, 2, and 7. However, the mega ball is in here. All right. So from type 2, let's open that up and say that we want just the regular numbers. All right, now today I'm recording this on August 17th, 2014. If you repeat these steps at any point in the future, you're potentially, definitely going to have different numbers that were the most popular numbers, but certainly at this point, we have 29, 49, 35, 10, and then there's a two-way tie for 23 and 47, all right? So you're going to have to choose, or maybe you play them both. I don't know, all right? The other thing that we could do here, it's kind of interesting, is we can take the year field and drag the year field up here, and we could say, well, hey, let's see just the data for 2014. Click OK, all right? So there the most popular numbers are 10, 29, 35, 47, and 13. Not a big change because, again, we're only looking at data in 2014 and the last part of 2013. Hey, I'm going to break in here. This is actually the next day when I'm editing the video. Another interesting thing to do would be to take the year field and move it over to columns. All right, particularly once you get more data, if you're doing this in 2015 or 2016, you can then see the most popular numbers for each of the years, and you're allowed to sort these columns either way. So you can choose one cell in the year and sort to see what was most popular, or we could also take the year field out and put the date field going across there. Now that's going to be a lot of data, I realize that. But when the date field is going across the columns, this drop down here under date filters allows us to choose various things like everything in the last quarter or everything in this quarter. So let's choose this quarter, and you'll have to scroll out to the right to the grand total to see which numbers were the most popular for all of those dates. Or this tip, for those of you who happen to be in Excel 2013 or newer, you don't even have to put the date field in the pivot table. This only works in Excel 2013. We come here to the Analyze tab and go to Insert Timeline, choose Date, click OK. And now our data, let's see, it should still be sorted high to low. Yep. So now we could choose a particular month. So if we wanted to see the most popular numbers in July or June, or you could even choose, you know, a range of dates using the timeline. Also possible to change this to quarters or years. So if you want to see everything from maybe the last 6 months or something like that, you could very quickly change the timeline and see the most popular numbers. Again, this is only in Excel 2013 and newer. It wasn't there in 2010 or 2007 or before. All right, back to the original video. But you can choose from the drop down here and see what the most popular numbers were in any year. So those are for the five regular numbers. To do the exact same thing for the Mega Ball, we'll choose 2014 here and change from regular to mega and click OK. And there are the most popular numbers. Actually, let's take the 2014 out and just do all draws since the beginning of the new game. All right, and again, a big tie there with 7, 10, 9, 13, and 15, each having come up 8 times since the game switched over. All right, now I'm going to be completely contrarian here and go the other way. Rather than choosing one of the popular numbers, I'm going to say that these 15 mega balls are all equal, and just the law of averages says that the number 4 is way overdue, right? That if I'm going to bet, the number 4 is way overdue. So I'm just going to do the contrarian thing here, and that's the beautiful thing about the lottery is everyone has their own system. You can choose what makes the most sense for you. All right. So my dad, who occasionally plays the Mega Millions, if it gets large enough, I'm going to pass these numbers along to him. And what do you think? 23 or 47? 23. I'm going to go 23. All right. That's our play for this week. And of course, again, assuming you see this at some point in the future and you follow these steps and download these numbers, you're going to get a completely different set of numbers. The video that people wrote about was 5 years old, so just imagine someone up in 2019 is watching this. You're going to have a much longer string of data completely different results every time. Here's another tip for those of you only in Excel 2010 or newer. We can actually get rid of these two filters here where you have to choose from the drop downs, and back on the it's called the Options tab in Excel 2010 or the Analyze tab in Excel 2013, we're going to insert a slicer, and we want slicers for type 2, for new game, and for year. Click OK. And I'm going to put all three of these slicers right on top of each other, so I'm going to take a little bit of time to resize them make them smaller, make them all fit up here. And year, I'm going to make that one wider. And for year, say that I want a bunch of columns. So up here in Slicer Tools Options, I can probably fit everything in two rows if I go with six columns. There you go. All right, so here's how a slicer works. So if we want to see just the mega ball for the new game in 2014 and 2013. So I choose 2013. Oh, here, wait, we have to clear this filter from the timeline. Choose 2013, 2014. I had to hold down the control key to do that. Just the mega ball, just the new game, and we'll see the largest numbers there. Or same period of time, I want to see the regular ball. There are the five. If I don't care about new game versus old game, I can just clear that filter and see the highest numbers over time for everything. So interesting way, lots of different kind of ad hoc what if analysis you can do with these slicers without having to use the drop downs. Good luck. I know if you win, you'll never have to watch the Mr. Excel podcast again. We'll miss you. Hey, by the way, if you want to save this file, okay, because we open a CSV file, you can't save a pivot table in a CSV file. You have to come here and do File, choose Save As, and most important, change it from CSV to XLSB, and you'll be good to go. All right, well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.